Good afternoon, sir. Thank you for joining us today at the event. So I have a certain set of questions that the entire IBS Gurgaon wants to know. Firstly, what impact does technology like artificial intelligence and blockchain will have an impact on the global economic scenario?
So you're talking artificial intelligence first. You know, artificial intelligence is a big word. It covers largely right now robotic and these auto-driven, self-driven cars. There are two sectors which are right now people talk about impact.
We are basically focusing on how the artificial intelligence that is taking place in today's scenario will impact the human force.
That's what I'm saying, that you have two areas.
Yeah.
One is robotic. They're creating robots for doing jobs. Second, there is a self-driven cars.
We are focusing on robotics,
but
the automatic.
So you think this will self-driven car has nothing to artificial intelligence?
It has, but mainly we are focusing on the human force.
Okay, human force.
Will the employability of human beings affect?
Of course, it's been affecting. Artificial intelligence is not new. You know, it was in a primitive form in 80s. Japanese started robots. You're in the factories, you go today, welding work, all that work is done by robots now. So it has already impacting and it will continue to impact. But it will also enhance our ability to think and act. You know, we might become more robotic ourselves. Kind of things which are happening in the world today is everything about you gets captured. Right. Artificial intelligence is beyond robotic, I think. You know, you have things like these devices which are coming in your houses, you know. You have Alexa, I'm just giving you a name. You have Adam, somebody has created it, you know. So the human interface is going to decrease, I think. So you're going to more interact with gadgets than you're interacting. You already seen how many people go and watch even, you know, things like televisions, things like mobile phones, things like gaming, which has come, you know, they are all artificial intelligence, extension of that basically. Anything which is not real is artificial,
yes.
Right? Even gaming is artificial. So I think we're going to have less and less human interactions. And of course, on job front, it will hit, but we always create new types of jobs. It's an evolving situation. Somebody was telling me yesterday that over time we had so many technological revolution and people questioned job will disappear, but new types of job came in. So I was exactly asking the same question what you're asking me. He said jobs market will evolve, they'll keep creating new types of jobs. So I hope it happens. But you know, I am more worried about self-driven cars. That's one sector which can hit job market big time, because whether it's USA, Europe, China, Asia, there are a lot of people depend on the car. And the car, not only one is the drivers you're talking about. Second, everybody wants to buy a car. What happens? Optimization happens. The car sharing will start once you have a self-driven car. Third, which is very important aspect, which we have done a lot of study. If you have a normal car, I know you don't want to discuss car, but I'm telling you this important part. Has 2,000 components. In a car. Electric car has only 20 components. So what happens is the auto ancillaries. You know, so many jobs. So I think it's a evolving situation. Right now there's no standard answer. It will definitely impact job, but nobody knows the degree of it. And nobody knows over what period of time, you know, it's going to happen. You see now you're talking of more, earlier robotic was more monotonous, like you're like welding job, monotone job. Now they are becoming more reasoning coming now. They are also, they're putting chips where they're doing human job in terms of analysis. Now tomorrow, now you see in the call center, BPO markets, they have lot of automatic things come there now. The voice recognition. You know, I am sure that you would have seen it, that
yes.
These days, earlier you call a call center, if you call the number, you will have to call the person, what do you want, what can I do? Now they say multiple option choice, they recognize your voice. And they give you solution also, robotic. So it will impact job, but I hope new types of job will evolve.
Thank you, sir. In the changing global economic scenario, what role does the management school like IFFIA will play?
I think because world is becoming very small, you know, when I was studying, there's no way I would have not what's happening in America, Japan. Today you got the news, you're talking about Trump, you know, trade wars, everything, all the news available today on this phone. You don't have to buy Financial Times. When I went abroad in 94, I was told, start reading Financial Times. And I went to South Africa first. And we used to get Financial Times 48 hours late in that country. So today technology has, you don't need to go to USA to learn what America is doing. You can learn from here. So as long as you productively use technology to read the right things, I'm constantly reading. Because if I'm not reading, I'd be out of the market soon. So we need to be basically constructively use technology to learn more and evolve.
And sir, what motivates you to be into more charity despite such a high business profile?
So charities is something I never speak about, but unfortunately it's now, because I've been doing for so many years, a lot of people know. And I've been doing from 2000 onwards, so it's 18 years now. Now it's obviously become a larger scale, and I like to do it under the radar, because you know, you feel it's a business when you start talking about it. So it's my lot of, she knows quite a lot, but she also doesn't know all my projects. Because, so what I've done is in my mind, I thought that I need to do something at larger scale. So I work with like WWF, Bernardo's. So these are large charities, I don't do fundraising for them. Then we have a foundation also. So 20% of our charity happens through a foundation, London. 80% I do personally, for simple reason that I'm not accountable to anybody. I don't need to tell anybody, because if I'm doing some foundation, we need to publish it. So 80%, that is a personal reason. You know, I feel that, you know, everybody has to think what they're doing in their life. You know, you will also think at one stage, because you will also die one day, you will get old. I also know that I'll also die. So in my mind, I had to find something which keeps me happy. So it's, I'm doing for me rather than for anything else. I'm not helping anybody. Help is a very weak word, you know. I never used the word help like helping or supporting or giving. Giving also a very strong, arrogant word, you know. So nothing belonged to, I started from nothing, I had nothing. Rajiv knows I worked with him. So God is very kind, He's given me a lot of resources. So the resources can be used productively, why not?
Basically, that is your motivating factor.
Motivating is just, I feel happy because something different I am doing. Personally, I feel it is my living life is worth living. Otherwise, if I keep collecting money in my account, that has no meaning. If I become more powerful, that has no meaning. If one day everything fades, you lose power. Money will stay here. Where, so for me, it's a personal reason. I feel happy about it.
That's really great, sir. So at last, what set of advices will you give to the budding management graduates like us?
Don't read a book and memorize. See the practical side of it. Relate to the actual what's happening action. No point reading. I think more India, more generally, I think the Western education and Indian education, I find there's a difference, that their practical aspect is very, very important. You know, you want to learn about stock market, open a small account. 2000 rupees, these days you can open an online account, start investing, you will lose money, but you learn.
Learn by doing.
Learn by valuation, what you're doing, do study. First, study, don't go by just, you know, must, whatever you're doing, action should be analyzed.
Yes.
Everything based on analysis. So you have the opportunity, we didn't have. Our time there was a DMAT, there was no DMAT accounts, we could not trade. Today you have world open to you, you can do whatever you like.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.